My life as an ex-Muslim is awesome without Allah, as are the lives of many ex-Muslims. If you're a Muslim and your life is awesome with Allah, okay, that's fine. It's pretty cool and amazing for you, I guess. What's not amazing is the fact that there are ex-Muslims being bullied, harassed, imprisoned, tortured, and killed. And if you are an awesome person, you shouldn't be standing for that, regardless of if you are awesome with or without Allah. Every day I'm hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling, hustling. Every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling.
Yakaladın yani, kesicen yani. Onları, ateistler, Allah'a inanmıyorlar. İnanmıyorlar Allah'a, işte ben inanmıyorum.
Hayvan abi onlar, insan değil.
Nasıl ya? İnsan abi, bildiğimiz insan. Nasıl hayvan oluyor?
Öyle insan olmaz abi. Yani bizim gibi insanlar değil onlar. Abi,
onlar hepsinin canı cehenneme. Öyle Allah'a inanmayan, yani canı cehenneme.
Allah belalarını versin. Yakaladığım yere tek tek onları, şırıngayla kanalarım onlardan.
Nasıl şırıngayla kanalarım?
Taktım mı arkadan çıkar.
Baba.
Ya ver şimdi baba, abi ateş işte. Allah peygamberine inanmış.
Tamam inanmıyor ama bir şey anlatmaz mıyız ona yani, anlatalım. Gidelim işte ama anlatalım ona.
Abi işte verelim, onlar da gırtlak bak kessinler.
İşte
canlı canlı böyle.
Ama insan değil mi onlar?
Nasıl yanmışlar abi?
Onlar cahil insanlar.
Nasıl yani cahil?
Gavurlar. Ya ne bileyim mi baba, onlar dümenci insanlar, yalancı insanlar.
Bizim, nasıl ya?
Evet, ateist ne demek? Şerefsiz bir insandır, şimdi yalan söylemeyelim.
Neden şerefsiz?
Çünkü Allah'a inanmayan insan, insan değildir. Hayvandır, hayvan da olamaz zaten. Hayvandı. Allah'a inanan bir insandır. Beyinleri yok yani.
Hi guys, this is Harris Sultan, the ex-Muslim atheist, and I am awesome without Allah. And you know why that is? Because I don't have to take my morals, my rules, and the code to live a life from 1400 years ago. This is why you can be awesome without Allah too. You don't have to believe that women are inferior to men. You don't have to believe that homosexuals are some cursed, diseased people. And you can also love your dogs as well. This is why I take my morals from my own evolving morality, and you can do the same thing. We know that we can learn about the world, about the universe through science and through discovery. We don't have to get anything from our scriptures, and that doesn't put a limit on your life. This is why I'm awesome without Allah, and you should be too.
Coming out of the closet as an ex-Muslim has helped me live my life to a much more freer extent. I don't have to pretend, I don't have to act in a certain manner or feel a certain way. There definitely has come with its risks that involve any, you know, potential issues for me and my family. Above all, I feel that the more and more of us come out and we normalize the dissent, this will only be better for us in the long run, because we are all there, we exist, and we have a right to exist.
If you're a closeted ex-Muslim, I'd like to tell you that it's not as difficult as you think it in your mind to be. And sure, you will lose a couple of friends and you will probably grow distant from some of your family members, like I did too. But you know what? It will be okay. I also used to consider the possibility of, what if I lost either of my parents, and what if I could never tell them who I really was or how I truly felt inside? That the last image that they would have of me was someone who I was not. We owe it to each other to start this movement, to spread this awareness, and we owe it to each other to make this happen.
I think the expungement of guilt is one of the greatest things that I could have ever felt. I lived my entire life feeling guilty for things that I would do. Watching a movie, listening to music, reading a book, hanging out with friends, whatever. If it wasn't related to Allah, I felt bad and I felt guilty. I felt guilty all the time, especially coming from a background of being in an Islamic school, full-time school from preschool until eighth grade. I think for those who are still stuck in the dark, what I want them to know is that we are here. There is a community here. Religions all across the world right now in 2019 are dying at enormous rates. The internet has connected everyone around us. Religions, castes, sex, cultures, all of these have built their foundations upon exaggerating the differences between people. But now we can all see that we are all the same.
coming out definitely has influenced me personally very positively, even though it has not influenced my brothers and my parents very positively, and they're very upset still after a decade. But I think anytime you're true to yourself, it's great if you could live an honest and true life. You don't have to worry about the fact that a God who set these laws of universe in motion is so worried about impurity during menstruation and doesn't like masturbation. So you look at the world with open eyes, no biases, and you figure out what is the right thing to do in a society.
I'm a good person. For the sake of being a good person, and not a shithead, bigot, judging people in your name. I'm not a terrible human being for you. I am a good person because I want to be a good person. And I think that speaks volumes. I no longer judge people based on how religious they are or what religion they follow. I don't contain myself in a bubble of practicing Salafi Muslims who, you know, read the Quran endlessly all day, who pray all the time, who were constantly guilty for tiny little things. I love people because they are deserving of my love, and I love everyone unconditionally because they are human and I love them. And that is something that you never gave me, and you never made me understand. You took away my concept of love, you took away my concept of happiness, you took away my concept of everything good in this world, and the only good thing there was you. And now, without you, everything in the world is good. All the pain I feel is good because I know that it's making me stronger. All the pain I feel is good because I know that it's keeping me human. All the happiness I feel is 10 times, 100 times, 1,000 times better than a moment spent talking to you. Because I'm living, and there's nothing bad about living.
After I left Islam, I started seeing life as it is. There is no father figure up there in the sky who can take care of me or burn me in hell. There's a lot of nice parts of living Islam. One of them being enjoying your life, not having to bow and kneel down to an imaginary figure, not fasting from sunrise and sun to sunset. Life in general, aside from the clarity in which you make your life decisions. It is important to be out, in my opinion, because it tells others that not everybody buys the nonsense of religion. Not everybody believes in superstition, and that in itself triggers their thinking process. Saying I'm an atheist or an ex-Muslim makes people think, why? I want to say to the in the closet ex-Muslims, we know you're there, we are with you, even if we can't do anything right now, but if the chance arises and if the need arises, we will do our best to protect you.
If you don't believe or feel a certain way, you don't need to feel pressured into believing something. You have this one life, and you have every right to live this life to its fullest. So we are here for you. We exist, and all you need to do is just reach out.